Folks say it started off as just rain, then it got heavier, then there was the lightning and the thunder, and just as Nicholas and Brittany D'Addario thought to themselves, I hope the power doesn't go out, it did, and then the sky lit up.
We thought our house was on fire. There was a huge explosion. It was all red in our room. We ran outside and could see that the tree was completely covering Mentor Avenue and sparks and cable lines down.
Large branches from a tree a few houses down from the D'Addarios near Garfield Road fell on the lines running along Mentor Avenue. A transformer blew as power lines were ripped from the tops of poles and twisted and torn apart. The lines in the tree limbs blocked the road for most of the day, reducing traffic to just one way east and westbound. 200 homes lost power at around 10 Tuesday night, and with high temperatures and high humidity, the outage couldn't have come at a worse time.
The worst thing was we were in our house with no air, and it was like 900 degrees in our house.
Folks here have brought out the generators to try to get through this, but even with the generator powering some fans in the fridge, it's still hot inside of Ray Newcomb's house. He says the power company told him it could be several hours or maybe even a whole day before he gets his electric back. Newcomb says, unfortunately, this is sometimes the price you pay to live on a quiet, tree-lined street.
This is a neighborhood where there's an awful lot of old trees, and a good storm, usually there's a problem of one sort or another, but hopefully this will be the end of it.